that I've had has pursued me throughout my life. It's something that changes based upon where I am.
But it had been shredded and filled with
like
interior oil, like all of the
physical environment that is displayed around me. It's some place I stumble upon, but not for many years. I'm quite a skeptic of many things and face my day-to-day, very firmly in reality. But it's something that has struck me as perhaps a fulfillment of potential. The dream starts off quite a little thing where
the
night enter, I wake and recognize that my physical form is
dancing.
And the moment I begin to recognize the fact, I fall forward.
Performing and auctioning.
I fall forward.
The way
I pinch outward. And before I can arrive, into some place where I land, and I'm made aware of physical sensations.
I remember
the way that I was rising to my collarbone, or resting inside of my chest. Not a temperature,
it's
something that resides in me that is entirely uncomfortable.
I kept on running down the stairs.
Every time I start walking, I recognize them, and I'm outside, and it's like a place I've never been before, and the colors.
And the professor had these three really little students who were going to cover for him, and they had this giant axe, and they were going to go over and saw his kids in the house.
I jumped in, and when I jumped into the water, I realized that it was actually a multiverse. It was a portal to the multiverse to go anywhere in the universe that I wanted. As soon as I jumped in the water, I felt an overwhelming wave of emotion, and I felt literally the entirety of the sum of humanity, where we were on a current timeline chronologically. I saw literally everything from one shape, one step away from.
And they grabbed the axe
from
and then
they
tried to throw it again. It didn't work out.
I saw that, you know,
inside
Rolling hills, blue waters, large rocky cliffs. Last night, I was walking through the prairie and led to the edge of a dark forest. And we walked into the forest, past the point where light could reach, until we looked and could turn back and only see a sliver of light across the horizon, cut up and down by the trunks of the trees. I don't know what that is.